There's Tigresa. Tigresa! Tigresa! Dog minds well. Hola, Luis.
Hola.
Luis is chopping down some of the weeds for us here. But here we got some lemon trees. Actually, the lemons in Ecuador are green, but they are lemons. We got lemons, we got orange tree right there. We've got a whole bunch of them. It's kind of cool, you can just come out here and pick lemons off the tree and go inside and make lemonade. We were just sitting inside, and it's a Saturday, and it's beautiful out, so we were wondering what we can do today. We decided we're going to make a trip up to Rio Verde, aka Green River, and they have a waterfall there called Pailon del Diablo, so we're going to check it out. So that was a bit rough. I began preparing pizza dough, because we're headed out for the day, and it's good to get your pizza dough started early so that it'll have time to rise. And, you know, when you have a family and you want to do day trips and things like that, it's always important to start planning your day early. And that's one of the things that my wife doesn't exactly like about me, is that I don't really plan anything until the day arrives. So what does that Bible verse say? Think not on tomorrow, the evil of the day is sufficient therein. I've mastered it. Anyway, had to run over all over the city looking for, that right there, which is basically yeast. This recipe that I have, I actually got this book right here. Let's see if I can get this on the camera. The pizza book. It's great. I picked it up for, $2 at Mrs. B's in Hendersonville, Tennessee. And it's got all sorts of recipes for doughs and stuff like that. And this one we're going to make today is a Sicilian dough, and it comes out really great. It comes out nice and crispy, and the secret to making it crispy is to just put in a little bit of
olive. You want a nice smooth area, and you want to throw some flour down because we're going to be kneading the dough a little bit. So what I've done is I've got 7 cups of flour. I've doubled the recipe because I got a family of 6. So now I'm just going to take a teaspoon of salt, and this recipe is in that book, and it's a great Sicilian dough. And all I'm going to take is my salt, and put it right in with my flour, just an all-purpose flour, and I'm just going to mix it up. I'm going to mix it all in good, and then once I got that integrated, I'm just going to make a hole in the middle, a nice well, and I'm going to put in my water. I think I got about, if I remember right, I think it was about 2 cups of water. I recommend picking up that book, guys. It has all different types of pizza dough that you can make right in the house, and then just make pizza. You save yourself all sorts of money. You won't have to go out anymore. So you just make a well right in the middle like that, and then I'm just going to take my water, which I think is about a cup and a half or 2 cups, and I'm just going to pour it right in the middle, and I'm going to do it little by little. I'm going to pour about half of it in, and then I'm going to start mixing. You don't want to do it all at once. Mix that in, and then I have a half a cup of oil as well, and this is the key guys to the crispy type of a dough. If you like a thin crust that's kind of crispy, you're going to want to put in some oil. So I'm just going to do it little by little, a little bit of oil, a little bit of water in my 7 cups of flour, and just start working it all in like this. Water. And then the last of it that I have to put in is going to be my yeast. So I'm going to come right over here, and all I'm going to do, guys, I like this nice big block of, it's like some type of a wet yeast that has to be stored in the fridge. And I'm just going to break off a nice big spoonful of it like that. I like to use a lot. It doesn't call for that much, the recipe, but this is what helps it to rise. So I'm going to use a good amount. I'm going to take that, and I'm just going to break it all up like this, and I'm going to sprinkle it right into my dough. And you want that to get nice and broken up. You don't want to have big chunks in there. You want to get it as fine as you can. Just drop it all in there like that, and that's going to cause my dough to rise. And we'll come back to it later on tonight, and it'll be risen and ready to make our pizzas. Now I'm just going to work it together like this with my hands. And I'm going to combine it into a nice mass that's going to be my pizza dough. Okay, guys, once you get it into a nice mass like that, what you're going to want to do is take it out, and we're going to put it right down on this table here. So I'm going to spread my flour around a bit, and we're just going to start kneading the bread, and or the dough, I should say. And I'm just going to do it like that, and then fold it back down like this, and press it down with my hands like that, and then fold it over from the sides like so, and then the other side like so. And guys, if it's not sticking together when you have it in the bowl in the beginning, you can add a little bit of water to it to get it all incorporated. Or if it's too sticky and it's really sticking to your hands, you can add a little bit of flour. So just play with it a little bit, flatten it out, fold it back over. And the good thing about this, guys, is you don't have to play with it too much. I just like to press it down like that with my hand, and then I'll fold in the sides like that, press it down with my hand one more time, then I'll come back and fold the other side like this, press it down, add a little bit of flour if I need to, fold it over like that, press it out again. And this isn't too wet or too dry, it's just right. I got this nice surface with some flour down, so look how it's not sticking to anything, it's not sticking to my hands at all, and this is gonna come out great. So I'm just gonna knead it like this for a little while. I believe this is gonna get that yeast incorporated into the dough, and then I'll let it sit in a pan or a pot. I'll cover it with either some saran wrap or a nice moist wet towel, and I'll just let it sit for like, I don't know, 8 to 10 hours. Come back, we'll make some pizza, some calzones.
So we're off to a bit of a late start. That pizza dough slowed us up a bit, but no big deal, we're on the road. Got our coffee, don't leave home without it, and my beautiful wife has taken the driving responsibilities over for the day. Said I got this eczema on my hands, and the doctor said that it's an allergic reaction, and it actually comes from the steering wheel. It's very interesting to be puzzling, but I've been battling with it for almost 2 years now. And so when I drive, I have to put these cotton gloves on, and it seems to help a little bit. Not much, but a little bit. And yesterday I went out to try to clean up the landscape of my house in the jungle in Canelos, because I'm going to try to sell it before we move back to the States, and I ruined my gloves. So, thus, my wife is driving. Hi, Delilah.
Hi.
So we just got here to Rio Verde, or Green River, and it really is a very pretty river, as you can see. Hi, Rosie.
Hi. Hi, Dave.
Hi, buddy.
Hi.
Beautiful day. Here on this bridge in Rio Verde. It's a beautiful, it's like a crystal clear river, but it's just got this green tint to it. Okay, so I just asked one of these guys, and he said that you just walk down this road for about 10 minutes. You come to a little wood house where you buy tickets, and then you get into the staircase that leads you right to the waterfall, Pailon del Diablo. So we just walked for about 10 minutes or so, and a long, narrow pathway, and it brought us up to this little, I don't know what you call it, resort-type place, and they have a little restaurant here, and a place to buy ice creams. And I guess somewhere around here we're going to have to buy some tickets and head right up that way to go to the waterfall. So they say 2 more minutes, and we'll be at the waterfall. We just got to climb this staircase here. Looks like there's some type of a trail in there. There's the waterfall. Pailon del Diablo. Rio Verde, Ecuador. It gets a little chilly here, folks. Guys, I just wanted to take a second to tell you that if you have a family and you have young kids and stuff, it's really important that you take time to get out and do types of stuff like this, like go on a day trip, go to see a river, a waterfall, or whatever there is in your area, because they're only going to be young once. And especially if you're into like teaching the Bible, doing Bible studies, and really active in your church, what you don't want is to spend all your time doing ministry work and studying and being involved in the church and neglecting your kids, because a lot of times what happens is that when the kids grow up, when they see a Bible, they associate that Bible with their father grabbing that Bible and walking out the door and leaving the kids in the house or going to study or going to the church and not being around. So it's really important if you guys have kids that you spend a lot of time with them. I know me, I have a real addictive personality. I used to be an alcoholic and a drug addict, and I can get addicted to anything. I can get addicted to my work just as easily, ministry work or whatever. So I have to be conscious of that, and I have to fight against that, and I have to take time out of my week to spend with my kids. That advice came from my pastor, Jim Brown, and it's also just something that I've come to know from my own personal experience. So guys, get out of the house, go on a day trip, spend some time with your kids, man. They'll only be young once. That was our trip to Rio Verde and Pailon del Diablo. It was probably about a 30-minute ride to get here. Then we spent a couple hours here. It actually got really cold down there by the water, the waterfall itself, but it was a nice trip. And managed to pick up some gloves so I can drive home. Delilah doesn't have to do all the driving. And also managed to pick up these hippie pants. And we're going to try to start a website, an online store, and sell some fine handmade Ecuadorian products when we get back to the States. So don't forget to check out our website and online store. Let's head back to Rio. The moment of truth. I've never had the dough not rise. So, Lord willing, today won't be any different. And there it is, definitely risen.
She's ready. I'm just gonna throw it on like this. Like so. A little more. And you can just put on the amount that you like. Okay, so now we're ready to throw our cheese on. We got our cheese mixture here. We got mozzarella, two different types of mozzarella. There's one that comes from this neighborhood that's right outside of Puyo. It's called Diez de Agosto, and they make the mozzarella cheese fresh. It is so delicious. We just peel strings of it off and eat it. And once you start eating, it comes in a ball. Once you start eating it, it's hard to stop. So we've got two types of mozzarella cheese. We've got some cheddar cheese and some, what's the name of that other cheese we're using? Parmesan cheese. So we'll just sprinkle it all over the top like so, and then we'll put our meats on. We have our toppings right over here. We're gonna go with some bacon. We're gonna go with some ham. And now I'm gonna put some vegetables on. I like green peppers on mine. Delilah doesn't like them on hers, so I'll do half the pizza with green peppers and half I'll leave them off. And that's the beauty of making these pizza pies in your own house, is that you can do what you like. You could put a cucumber on it if you want. Not that we'd do that, right, Rosie? Yeah.
I like green pepper.
Pizza. Delilah says she likes a cucumber on her pizza.
No, green pepper.
Green pepper?
I don't like the tomatoes.
Oh, she doesn't want tomatoes. So then I'll cover the whole thing. Well, now I put them all on one side. I'll cover the whole thing with my green peppers, like this. Move them around a bit. That's a little better. Now it's on pretty much the whole pizza. And now we'll throw down some of our nice onions. These are some nice white onions we have here. Spread them all over. And she doesn't like tomatoes. I like nice fresh tomato wheels on my pizza. It is absolutely delicious. If you have never tried that, you're missing out. You gotta put fresh tomatoes on your homemade pizza. Okay, so here they are. They're not exactly wheels. I guess Delilah didn't know exactly what I liked when she prepared these slices of tomatoes, but I won't hold it against her.
I made the wheels and then I cut them in half.
And I don't know why. So, let's see. I'd like to cover the whole thing with tomatoes, but I won't. I'll be a gentleman. I'll put one more on right there. That is nice, but now it's not quite done. Now we have to do one last piece of business, and that is to go over it all one more time. Some nice fresh mozzarella, cheddar, parmesan blend.
Our first pizza has come out of the oven. We're just about to cut it up and dig in.
Even as you bless to our bodies, we thank you for all the blessings we have in this life, Lord. We know we're not worthy of these things. Help us to be worthy, Lord. Help us to repent of sin. Cause the repentance in us. Help us to bow to your will, Lord. Help us to be bold witnesses of truth and of Jesus in this lost and dying world. Continue working in our lives, Lord, molding us to the image of Christ through the preaching and teaching of your word. We give you the glory and the honor in Jesus' name. Amen.
What's the first piece? Oh, it looks like Aaron's already got it. There goes that. Aaron, be careful, pal.
Daddy,
it's going to be hot, okay? So you be careful with that. Who else wants some? All right, dig in, guys. You can go ahead. Let me know what you think. Is it hot? It's cooled off good? You got the best piece? All right, well, then eat it. How's yours, Ab? How is it, Aaron? Is it yummy? Okay, and here we have our second pizza, the white pizza, which is mozzarella cheese, Alfredo sauce, chicken, broccoli, and spinach. And that one is going to be delicious. How is it, Rosie?
Yummy.
Yummy? What do you think, Lily? Still hot, or is it cooled off?
It's cooled off.
Good? What do you say, Ab? So we're just taking out the last of them. This is the second calzone.
just about done. Take it out, put it over here with the other one, and we'll dig into those, eat them with the rest of this pizza. I'll have to look over my notes a little bit because it's Saturday night. I have church first thing in the morning, and that's a wrap.
This old man came rolling home. This old man, he played ten. He played knick-knack once again with a knick-knack, paddywhack, give a dog a bone. This old man came rolling home.
Yeah, good job, guys.
¿Quién es el justo en este contexto? El justo es Jesús. Jesús sufrió por los injustos. Entonces, ¿quiénes son los injustos? Son los elegidos. Habla de nosotros, ¿no? Los creyentes, los elegidos. Jesús sufrió por los elegidos, los injustos. ¿Y para qué?
Para